was the headline, UNC co-ed found dead in her off-campus apartment.
There's what?
There's blood everywhere.
I don't know of anyone that I've ever met that knew Faith had a problem with her. I mean, everybody just loved her.
I don't know what happened.
The note was left there. It's like, who leaves a note at all? Like, why would they even do that?
Was this the killer leaving a hint behind? And if so, how bold, how brazen, how arrogant?
There's too many unanswered questions.
Who would want to do this to her?
Her family sent her off to college with the dream of her reaching her dreams, but it actually turned out to be their nightmare.
Friday morning, September 7th, 2012. At an off-campus apartment, University of North Carolina student Karina Rosario comes home after spending the night with a friend.
Zara 911, where is your emergency?
I just walked into my apartment and my friend was just, like, unconscious.
The victim is 19-year-old Faith Hedgepeth, also a UNC Chapel Hill student.
Okay, you say your friend is unconscious?
He's unconscious. I just walked in the apartment and there looks like there's blood everywhere.
This isn't how anyone thought it would end for Faith Hedgepeth.
She comes from a small community, but she has really big dreams.
Faith Hedgepeth grew up in a very small town called Hollister, North Carolina. It's a very small community. Under 1,000 people live there. And it has a Native American tribe, which Faith Hedgepeth is a part of, the Halawasaponi tribe.
It's a very remote community, 20 to 30 miles from any town, very little health care in the area.
Faith always wanted to be a pediatrician. She loved kids. She wanted to be a doctor.
Her goal was to move back to the tribal community and to make it more accessible.
My mom had just left my dad right after she was born, so I helped Mama a lot with her. She was kind of like my baby for all her life.
Faith was our baby sister. My mom and my sister, you know, they pretty much, raised her.
Faith was very involved in church activities, community activities, school activities. She wanted to make our community better.
She was a smart student, one of the top students in her school.
She has really big aspirations, and she ends up getting accepted to what the state considers is its flagship state institution, the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill.
Faith was always a Tar Heel fan. Our family we were Tar Heel fans.
I mean, we were a Carolina family, and she just had it in her mind that she wanted to go to Carolina no matter wherever else she got accepted to, she wanted to go to Carolina.
My dad went to school there for a year, so she wanted to fulfill his dream also and finish.
As a result of all her hard work, she was awarded a Gates Millennium Scholarship, and that scholarship was a full boat ride all the way through grad school.
She loved Carolina.
It's funny because everybody I ended up meeting also knew her. Even if I randomly met someone else, if I mentioned her name, they also knew her. They had mutual friends through her, and they would all say the exact same thing, just nothing but positive things to say, just because of how she would treat you and how she treated other people.
She was beautiful, happy, and sweet, so I think guys were just naturally drawn to her and attracted to her.
Faith attracted plenty of male attention at college, but had a high school sweetheart back home.
The last week of Faith's life, we actually spent a lot of time together, and she knew she still loved him and would eventually want to find a way for the two of them to work out their relationship and be together.
Juggling her part-time jobs, a busy social life, and her biology major is a challenge.
Adjusting from high school, small town, predominantly Native American communities, we both struggled with the academic rigor of UNC, but also just the cultural shock.
Anyone that went to UNC had a shock when they got there. You know, like, am I supposed to be here? Just because it is an adjustment from what you're used to.
Faith decided to take a break from academics. She did stay in Chapel Hill. Faith was working several jobs.
Her goal to always become a pediatrician, but she was starting to think maybe teaching might be a good profession for her.
When she got the news that she had gotten back in school, she called me at work and she said, "Mama, I got back in." She was just so happy. I mean, she was just over the top of the moon, you know, as they say. But it was for a short time before everything happened.
I still remember it like it was yesterday.
I got a call from Connie. She said, "You need to come to Chapel Hill. They found Faith dead."
She called me, and she, the first thing that she said was that Faith's dead.
People were stunned, especially students. They go to school there with the expectation that they're going to be safe. You had a lot of UNC students that felt like, okay, if this can happen to her, am I going to be put at risk? Am I in danger?
4 years earlier, Eve Carson, UNC student body president, was murdered in an off-campus robbery.
People were trying to draw the connection between the two, and it was a very chilling effect because that happened just several years prior. And just like Faith Hedgepeth, Eve Carson was very popular on campus.
There's heartbreak everywhere. Each time I went back to Hollister to interview her family or interview people in the community, everyone was heartbroken. They couldn't believe what had happened. This young, beautiful, vibrant, loving, caring young woman is killed and killed viciously. No one ever had a single negative thing to say about Faith. She was always described as someone full of light, someone who was willing to share that light, someone who was willing to help others.
We didn't know anything. I asked the questions. I asked, what happened to her? Did someone stab her? Did someone shoot her? What happened? They couldn't tell us.
Rumors, of course, started to go around the campus community. How did she pass away? What was the cause of death? Nobody knew that. So different rumors were going around.
We asked, could we go to the crime scene? Connie was begging, couldn't she go in the room where she was and just hold her hand? We knew she was still there. They hadn't removed the body.
They wouldn't let us go see her. I won't touch anything. I said, but she needs to know that I'm there, that, you know, her mom is there. She was all alone.
Faith spent her last night like many college students, a stop at the library, and then headed out to a popular night spot.
If you think about that night, if she's at a club, she's an attractive young girl. No doubt she had admirers in every corner of her life. So who did she encounter that evening?
That was the headline. UNC co-ed found dead in her off-campus apartment.
There's what?
There's blood everywhere.
I don't know of anyone that I've ever met that knew Faith had a problem with her.
I don't know what happened.
The note was left there. It's like, who leaves a note at all? Like, why would they even do that?
Was this the killer leaving a hint behind?
Everybody's a suspect.
Someone's was jealous of her.
Who would have the motive? Who would have the opportunity? And who would have the ability to commit this crime?
There's too many unanswered questions.
Who would want to do this to her?
Her family sent her off to college with the dream of her reaching her dreams, but it actually turned out to be their nightmare.